If you give a little more than you take, if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on the knees.
Vous avez une sur les moments. Vous commencez sur le système en grand scale. In the demand of the Almighty God, by the Father, the one who sent his Son Jesus Christ to be our redeemer, by which Christ we are here and who they alone have salvation. As we call the life of our system, let us be comforted by the word of God.
By supporting some of the projects. mention Andrea's writing skills before I did. I can remember her flow, planning a tree planting project while she was the president. When it was to be executed, for whatever reason or the other, only Andrea and the man who should assist with the digging of the holes turned up. Well, the project was done. And the article that Andrea produced highlighting the project, you would have thought it was the world and his wife were present. Although there was no mention of who were or who were not present. She was a masterpiece at the written word. So when I asked Andrea, I said, Andrea, I thought you said only you alone turned up at the project. Her response was, Glenda, you see anywhere in the article that I mentioned that other people were there? I rest my case. Her commitment to the cause of humanity was extraordinary and commendable. She gave her best then to ensure success was achieved for the individuals and the organization she supported. She gave her all. She gave her all celebrating the cause, and I'm sure one in the audience today can attest to the fact. At the end of her tenure as president, the club was bestowed distinguished status, thus earning for herself the title of distinguished president. I always wondered, and I usually ask her, Andrea, how you put that so long? And she would explain, you no worry, you can carry me anywhere you want to go, and we will have a good laugh. Andrea became a naturalized Jerichonian because of her frequent visit to my hometown, Jericho, every now and then. So, the Jerichonians, they bestowed her the honorary naturalized Jerichonian. When I visited home alone, especially during the planning of our community homecoming, they would ask, where's your friend? It makes me really sad to know she's no more. The last time we conversed, the sight of adversity she was experiencing, she was cheerful and optimistic about her health. I promised that I would take something for her. And she said, let me tell you something, Glenda. If you're taking anything, take closer now. I was happy that she did tell me what she would prefer to save me the trouble of guessing of what to take. Every day I remember and take concern for Andrea, but always putting it off. I was putting it off for tomorrow and tomorrow and tomorrow. It's not like I could not afford it. Just did not find the time because I believe she was going to be around tomorrow and tomorrow and the next day and the next week. I have come to realize that time waits for no man. Do what you need to do today and to be alone. So today, as I pay tribute to a helpful and caring friend, I will miss the long hours of conversation we usually have. I will miss the jovial rendezvous we shared. I will miss the laughter. But I will preserve the warmth of having met a good individual. Her life was a blessing. Her memory will remain in our minds. Andrea, we are deeply saddened by your loss, but grateful for the time we had together. Our beloved friend, you may have left us far too soon, but your loving presence will endure forever in our hearts and souls. Sometimes in the way at times. These are some of the life lessons I'm trying to understand. But it is said, the Lord brings the best from the garden. A flower is preserved today and beyond for that great reunion when I look forward to meeting my friend again. Rest well, Andrea. Gone but not forgotten. May your soul find eternal peace. And thank you.
Thank you very much. We have signed us this neighbor. Here is his name. She can go now and share for us the sections.
who has left an enduring impact on our school. Her passing has left an empty space in our hearts, and as members of the school family and past students and past staff members, we know what we are talking about. The message she has left an empty space in our hearts. However, her contribution will continue to inspire and motivate us for generations to come. Andrea was a true visionary. She was always seeking means and ways of getting help for Bethel in order to improve and enhance teaching and learning. And I can say that without a shadow of a doubt, because I was there when Andrea was on the road. She was somebody who would walk around and just look, and wherever the need was, she would try to help. So with unwavering determination and relenting passion, she single-handedly sought out sponsorship to repair the roof, and I could guess it. At that point, it was like a seal, the roof of the auditorium. It was seal-like. You understand what I mean? When it rained, fall, once it began, it looks overcast, and you weren't in the auditorium. You had to move out and look somewhere that would be dry. Two Peace Corps workers, the Browns, came to Bethel at one time, and they gave us a number of drums to use as garbage bins, and they were stored in the auditorium. And whenever it rained, somebody had to be there moving around with the drums to catch water. Andrea saw that, and she decided to run with it. Although she knew that it would cost in the millions to repair the roof, because most of you here would know the size of the auditorium, and that to put on a new roof would cost an arm and a leg. But Andrea, being the person she was, decided that she was going to run with it. So her tireless efforts, coupled with her determination, led her to a kind-hearted female by the name of Anne Torcivia, an American. And Andrea put her case to the lady. She could not resist Andrea's pleas for help, so she decided to visit the school and assist. The rest is history. A roof that cost over millions was in place over a period of months. All to the instrumentality of the Scarlet. So after this mammoth task, one would think that Andrea would take a break. Not so. She would come up from time to time and walk the classrooms, and she realized that the flooring of the classrooms were contained a lot of potholes. And if you understand, right, Mr. Shirts? If you understand potholes in the classroom, that teachers who wear sight heels, that it would be a task to traverse those floors. And they decided that was not good enough. And so she was going again to seek sponsorship. And that she did. Andrea to the rescue again. And before long, there was mass construction on the flooring of classrooms at Bethel during a summer break. And a number of classroom floors were reconstructed. And they were not just paved with concrete and, you know, but she saw to it that the finish was a glossy, like, pretty looking floor. So that when you look at it, you could almost see your face. And Andrea said, good. That is what is needed in the classroom for children to learn and for teachers to take pride in their teaching. And, you know, one thing that Andrea did and it really stood out was that she did not seek to take glory for herself with these classrooms. So the different sponsors, she went out and she did plaques with the names of the different sponsors. And she hung each plaque in the classroom that that sponsor would have contributed to. And so we as a staff and as a school, we said, thank you. And she did not just stop there. She moved around again. I told her that she was like, remember, staff there. And she realized that there were students who were without school supplies. And again, she set off in the direction of seeking sponsors. And she went and she found persons who willingly contributed to backpacks and books and pens and pencils, ruler, all different types of school supplies. And Andrea gathered up all these big bundles up and she came up and she had a presentation and she presented to the students. That's the person that we are saying goodbye to today. Bethel is better off today. All because Andrea's child, a past student, decided that she was going to come in and to do her best. There are also other goodies, a lot more, and I'm sure Mrs. Johnson will mention some. And if I ask Mrs. Shreves to take the mic, Mrs. Shreves would have mentioned others, Mrs. Dittmas, Dinah would have mentioned others. There are no things that she did behind the scene. And as the person spoke before said, you can't understand how Andrea moved around because she was not a fat person, but she moved around briskly and purposefully. Miss Carly was present at almost every function of the school. Almost every function of the school, Andrea was there doing whatever she could, fitting in different capacities. So through her selflessness and generosity, Andrea showed us the true meaning of assisting our alma mater. She demonstrated that even one person can make a difference, and that our individual actions can collectively create a profound effect. As we say goodbye to a dear friend and past student, we take comfort in the fact that our legacy will live on and will continue to inspire Bethel Primary to strive for excellence.
Good morning, church.
But I had, Lord, give me strength to
visited primary school of the group.
First lesson, Psalm 22, shall be read by Mr. Yakis.
And the followed
by the second lesson, Romans chapter 8, verses 31 to 39.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in the green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, with my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. There is a portion of God's holy word. Thanks be to God.
Good morning, everyone. This scripture reading is taken from Romans 8, verse 20. Verse 31 to 39. What shall we then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? If God be, no, he that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifies. Who is he that condemned? It is Christ that died. Yea, rather, that is risen again, who is even at the right hand of God, who also maketh intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress, our persecution, our famine, our nakedness, our peril, our sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Scarlett. And not known author, rats crossing over. Oh, please don't feel guilty. It was just my time to go. I see you are still feeling sad, and the tears seem to flow. We all come to earth for a lifetime, and for some time, or for some, it's not so many years. I don't want you to keep crying. You're shedding so many tears. I haven't really left you, even though it may seem so. I have just gone to my heavenly home, and I'm closer to you than you know. Just believe that when you say my name, I'm standing next to you. I know you long to see me, but there's nothing I can do. But I still send you messages and hope you understand that when your time comes to cross over, I'll be there to take your hand. I believe that would be Andrew's message to us. She was a bright child who excelled in almost every area. She was quite a talker, as her friend Glenda said. And of course, her mouth got her into trouble many, many times, both at home, in the community, and at school. After leaving basic school, in social anthropology and politics. Angela Scarlett was a skilled journalist, even though she was trained formally in journalism. She was skilled in interviewing, and she was great at public discussions. And I always encouraged her, Andrew, why you don't get into politics? Because you are so good at persuading people to do the things that you want them to do. And we always joke, and I would say to her, girl, you can sell ice to an Eskimo. Her journalism skills led her into a collaboration with Germaine Bell of JBL Entertainment TV. And she created and produced and hosted the Scarlett Avenue Show, a well-watched show on Facebook. It began airing during the COVID-19 pandemic. And I invite all of you to go on Facebook, where episodes, all episodes of the Scarlett Avenue Show are still available. And those are really keeping her memory alive. Jean and Marva remembers with joy, the troubles that they would get into because of Andrew. You see, Andrew was a sickly child, very small and skinny. And if she cried, May, Marva, and Jean would get a good spanking from their dad, because he felt that she was too tiny to hurt them. They had to be the troublemakers. In fact, it was quite the opposite. She got many nicknames growing up. Her sisters gave her some of them. Coxie was one of her nicknames. Because when Grace and Maggie just started dating Coxie, nobody in the house knew of Coxie. But Andrea would come home and talk about Coxie. And every time they went to the shop, the only thing that Andrea wanted was Coxie. So she got the name Coxie. Was another name, because she was so skinny. And then Miss Hunter, she got that one because of the way she spoke with her British accent, especially when she got upset, all that British accent would come out. And because of her poise and elegance, just like the character of Miss Hunter on Lime Tree Lane. One evening a man visited their home. The man wanted to talk to their dad, Master George. And the dog ran out at this man, and the man didn't know how to defend himself. The only small thing he saw beside him was little Andrea, Mama McRae, and he took her over and flung her at the dog. And that brought about a big laughter, yes, in the home, because the man saw as the only shield. So Andrea went through quite a lot from early. Poor dog. Poor Andrea. And the Scarlett was the eloquent and glamorous Hanoverian, frank and outspoken, and one who loved and maneuvered social media very well. The last time I visited Andrea, she went into her treasured jewelry box, and this scarf/necklace I'm wearing today. She took it out. She was unable to walk very well, but she went in and she got it, and she brought it to me, and she put it around my neck. I was wearing a black dress, and she said, "This is how you wear it, my friend. I've never given you anything, but I'm giving you this necklace. Wearing it with pride." And she can't see me today, neither can she hear me, but I'm wearing her scarf necklace with pride. And I know I look as glamorous and elegant as Andrew.
your womb. In her will I live. Yes, yes. And she loved her family very well. She loved her nephews very well. She always thought of them. She loved her sisters, Jean and Marva. Jean did so many things for her during her illness. And Marva was her solid in a cook. Thank you so much for that. But I want to tell you that there are three children who Andrea loved more than anything else in this world. Her grandnieces Tia and Alia, and her grandnephew Alde. And at the time I met with Andrea, she had to ask me, how are they doing in school, Mrs. Johnson? Girls and boys, your auntie loved you more than anything else in the world. And you might not know, but you three were her world. When she spoke of Alvin, his mischievous smile came across her face. She had only two friends, even though she knew many, many people. But there were two who stood out. Glenda, even before I knew her. Mrs. Dwyer, there was never a conversation with Andrea, and she never spoke about Mrs. Dwyer. There were others, but those two she spoke about. Andrea was diagnosed with diabetes. In 2018, she had a stroke and was unable to walk without the use of a cane for a few months. Since then, though she was strong and got about performing her regular duties, traveling, teaching, doing her show, seeking donations and sponsorships from many schools in Hannover, serving on school boards like Open Eye and Merlin Audley High School, being with Tuan's Club, and doing several projects, she was still sick. In 2023, she went to Canada to visit friends and had a stroke there and had to return quickly to Jamaica. On her return, the medical team that had responsibility for her health diagnosed a heart condition for which she was being treated. Shortly after, she had a fall that damaged her cervical spine, which is the top part of the spine. Her recovery was slow, but she was able to walk around and do her daily tasks. She was hospitalized a few times between 2023 and 2024 for a variety of medical illnesses. But even so, Andrea was happy and strong. And she was one of the few persons I know who, even during sickness, she had that big smile on her face and that laughter. And when she was finished talking with you, you were empowered and you felt that you were the best person in the world, because that's how Andrea would make you feel. On June 2 and 3 of this year, she turned into Kingston for business. On the afternoon of Wednesday, June 5, she went to Jean's house, telling Jean and Mama that she was sick and wanted to go to the hospital. Her sisters took her to the Garland Homes Hospital, where she was admitted. Tests and treatments were administered, but sadly, in the wee hours of Saturday, June 8, 2024, Andrea Angeline Scarlett took her last breath. Those of you who did know her, you realize that we will miss her laughter, her funny ways of saying things, and the sparkle in her big round eyes. I met Andrea 7.5 years ago. That meeting blossomed into a wonderful and beautiful friendship. Andrea and I traveled Jamaica, because I loved to drive. And she would like me by my side many times. Together, we ate dozens of pounds of fried fish and roast breadfruit and bami. We had lots of conversations and jokes and laughters. And I will miss my friend dearly.
and we had an inside joke. Every time I visit her, she would say, Jasmine Johnson, you better came. Only Beverly Williams might know that inside joke. You better came. Andrea, you better came for you today. The fact that you are no longer here will always cause us pain, but you are forever in our hearts until we meet again. Andrea Angeline Skye, born September 16, 1974, died leaving her two sisters, Marva and Jean, nephews, nieces, grandnephews, and grandnieces in the wee hours of June 8, 2024. Andrea, my dear friend, may your soul rest in peace and perpetual light shine upon you. Today, we all are here to bid you farewell. Yes, Andrea, we thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Johnson, for this remembrance. You will be here on the house and job. We thank God for her life. We will have an item by staff member of the Vigil Premise.
Good morning, everyone. Isn't God good? Yes, man, in spite of we serve an awesome God. Amen. And I just want to say condolences to the family on behalf of the Bethel family. All right, I just want to encourage you with this song that says, ride out your storm. Hallelujah. You've been in the storm, and it seems like forever. Your nights of confusion. Your ship has lost anchor, and the storm's got you drifting. Just hold on to Jesus and ride out your storm. Ride out your storm. God is there with you. You may not feel but your morning is coming. Just hold on to Jesus and ride on.
For tears. And of course, you look at the text,
Mary and Martha, they did not think that Jesus Christ could raise Lazarus. But one thing they knew, that he could have prevented him dying. They heard about him, they have experience with him, but not to what extent that he could pull Lazarus back from the grave. So this was the conversation I've seen in verse 1. Let me try, because I believe in myself. But this is more, the community with people will always come and to give you kind of support, as you have been seen here for Sister Andra. And somehow, Martha should stay in the house. But instead of staying in the house, when she heard about Jesus Christ, she wanted to give Jesus Christ a message. Passing of the unique body. Martha said to Jesus Christ, Lord, if you had been here, if my body will not have died. That's what she believed. But Jesus Christ will teach her what she doesn't know. But she said something to Jesus Christ, but even now I know that God will give you whatever you ask of him. And apparently Martha was telling God, and Jesus said, God will bless and forgive his soul, and so on, whatever you ask. You may say to God, forgive the soul of my body, please, that will be something. Jesus said to her, your body will live, we will rise again. And there was a two conversation, and when Jesus Christ said, your body will rise again, Martha said to him, I know. And she said, I know that he will rise again in the resurrection on the last day. She was referring to that resurrection, but Jesus Christ was referring to his resurrection. Because he said that he is Lord, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And Jesus Christ said, he is the resurrection not for that day, but for this day. He can manifest his power anytime, at any place, in the life of who believes.
It shall be given to us. The community, we as a community will gather to give context to our life and to thank God for our self-esteem.
Jesus Christ is the Son of God. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered in the righteous Father, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he was again from the dead. He ascended to heaven. And he seated at the right hand of the Father. We will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of sin, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of the body, the life everlasting. Amen. Please be seated. Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. You are seated for the world. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those trespassing against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We know that neither death nor life, nothing to prison, nothing to come, no height, no death, no any other creature can separate us from the love of God Jesus in Christ Jesus for us. We know that in this heavenly house, our eternal God is all. We have a building from God, a house not made with man, eternal in heaven. Since St. Andrew has departed out of this life, and Almighty God in His mercy has taken her to Himself, we come into her body to be to ashes, dust to dust, ashes to ashes, and earth to earth, ensuring certain hope for the resurrection of eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. I heard a voice from heaven say unto me, from henceforth, blessed are the dead. Who died in the Lord.
Thank you.
the great shepherd of the sheep by the blood of his inner covenant. Make you perfect in everything to do his will. Work in you that which is pleasing in his sight. To this also, whom is the glory forever and ever. Amen. With this being said, I will also cast it in the door, and after that, we will join us.
If you give a little more than you take, if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down underneath, lend a voice to those who cannot speak. If you shine your little light, give sight to the ones who lost their way. There's a place for people like you. 'Cause I've heard that through the streets are made of gold. When you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, yeah, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeve, you're trying to be the change you wanna see. If you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like you. 'Cause I've heard that through the streets are made of gold. When you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, yeah, there's a place up there for people like you. There's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, yeah, there's a place up there for people like you. I know you out there, keep doing what you do. There's a place.